That's Steve, the whistler Herbst. Right, he's not whistling Dixie. He's whistling from Mozart's Turkish Rondo, but then you knew that. But did you know you're listening to the man who won first place this spring in the International Whistlers Competition at Lewisburg, North Carolina, the Super Bowl of whistling? He did it whistling.
The Hungarian Rhapsody number 2.
Blew away the competition. And there was plenty of it. In case you're wondering if it's in the genes, not the whistler's mother's.
Not a big whistler.
It was the whistler's father.
My father was a whistler and he inspired me and I just started whistling wherever I went.
No duets here, not yet. The whistler's parrot, Verde, doesn't. Were you wondering, does he, you know. The whistler is a senior VP at a New York ad agency.
Does anybody ever say, could you not, could you, do you mind?
Oh yeah.
He's not listening, he's only your boss. Do you enjoy this?
The whistling or the advertising?
Well, it could be an acquired taste. He's whistled at Carnegie Hall. So how do you do it?
You just put your lips together and blow.
Not exactly. For one thing, you don't just blow. You excuse the expression, Mr. Clinton, inhale.
That was all in. I've been whistling since about age 7 or 8.
And yes, he told the Florida Public Radio interviewer he's got a CD. And you can even catch clips on the web. Or take a walk down 2nd Avenue for a free concert featuring New York's own Steve, the international whistler champion, Herbst. Morry Alter, CBS 2 News.